guys, this is just a short video. It's going to Dane quickly. He asked me to help him put on the bonnet, just to hang the bonnet up, because he's spraying the bonnet of the EG. Then I'll just show you guys a quick update on the EG that he's busy with as well. That is basically respraying, full respray. So I just thought I'd make a video and show you guys update what the car looks like, as well as what he has repaired, and basically the outcome of what it looks like right now, or the progress on what it looks like right now, and then I'll just show you guys the end product once it's done as well. He did mention that he's doing a few upgrades to his Accord, so I'll maybe just assist him with regarding that. And then there's also a rear fog light that he has for his Civic, which I will be fitting as well. So I'll just show you guys a quick update on the EG. I just arrived to his house. Guys, this is what the EG looks like right now. There was a rust repair here. I don't know if you guys recall in the previous video, we removed the rear window. And there's also some rust repair over here that is now fixed. Must you still sand it, or?
Polishing.
So it'll still be sanded for polishing. So the bonnet still need to be sprayed. Dane just needs me to help him hang it for him. But as you guys can see, it's actually a very good outcome. Body's still straight. The thing was never an accident, it's just respray.
Yeah, and rust repair.
So just respray and rust repair. Come out pretty good. The color. Is the original color is usually a little bit darker, if I'm not mistaken?
The car was respayed twice.
Easier before.
So we just made it the color it was well before I sprayed it.
So you didn't go for the original?
No.
Is it burgundy or maroon?
Is it both?
Both. Isn't the purple ones, called burgundy? Like a kind of a purplish color? The Civics usually come out. A few of the EGs came out with it.
Yeah, there's a pretty good looking car there.
Also see these bumpers still need to be sprayed as well. This is the rear bumper. And this is the front bumper. Bumpers are already primed. So they're basically ready for spray. Thank you. my dudes, welcome back to the vlogs. So today is just going to be a short video. Might just be an intro to the next video as well. So as you guys saw in the video prior to this, I am removing the bootlet from the EG. The reason for that is Dane has mentioned that the tax set we have already done, it's a little bit too little, I would say. So basically we just have to tack it a little bit more so that it gives it a better structure or better strength. The reason for that is so when we do bond it or body fill it, that it won't crack when we do the install again. So basically the quick latches does have these Allen keys. I think it's 3 Allen key screws that you can basically push up just to give it a better alignment or better strength. So when you do push it up, that might just bend the welds that we have done, and that might cause it to crack. So we are going to do that basically today. And then another thing that we do plan on doing is, like I mentioned previously, there is a lot of other vehicles going to come to the vlogs. This is a German engineering vehicle. I'll show you guys in a bit. The reason for us fetching the car, I'll just show you shortly. Basically what we are going to do is, the car is red, so it has a lot of scratches on it. And a red car and usually a black car, the scratches are extremely visible on those type of vehicles or on those type of colors. So what we're going to do today is basically take the car to a previous sponsor, which is External Shine. You guys might assume, why am I not taking the Sali? Unfortunately, Sali has left the city, so he no longer will be sponsoring me going forward. He did mention that he will be returning, so we might just pick up from there when he does return. So we are taking the car to External Shine just for an inspection, just to see if he is able to remove the scratches and if the scratches are too deep. He did mention that we do plan on doing a 3-stage detail, and then he's also doing a clay bar treatment. I'm not too clued up exactly on that, or the information on that, but when we do link up with him, I'll just maybe just ask him and inform you guys as well. So going forward, that's what we are going to do today. Like I mentioned, this might just be a short video or an intro to the next video. So another issue that we might be sorting out today as well is my alarm system on the red Honda. So I don't know if you guys had the same issue before, but with my remote, whenever I press it, it does sometimes not work and sometimes it does work. So what we are going to do today is I'm going to use the spare remote that I had from my previous car, my white car, and then I also have a spare key for the red car. So we are going to assemble those parts, or maybe use the spare remotes that I had, and then just maybe take it to a place that can use all of those spares, and then just create one remote that is at least working for me. So that is also what we're going to do today. If you guys do have any knowledge or maybe can assist me with fixing the remote, please DM me or maybe just mention in the comments. It will be highly appreciated, because this is an ongoing problem that I actually had with my white car as well. I don't know if you guys have seen my white EG. I'll just put up a picture over here just to show you guys. But yeah, going forward, that is what we are going to do today, or that is what we have planned for today. So let's get started. Yo guys, I just went to go fetch the new German engineering car. Like I mentioned, we are going to basically take the car for an inspection. I did just inspect a few scratches. Then also, the owner of the car, I've assisted her with a few of her other cars previously before. So she just gave me a little gift. Isam vodka that she gave me. So just also like to say thanks to her. And then also, like I did mention, we are going to fix my remote keys. This is the spare keys. So I'm just going to take this to a shop and see if they can maybe assist me making maybe one of them at least work. As you guys can see, this isn't working right now. So the car that we also have is a A45. It's a pretty cool car, all-wheel drive. I'll just show you guys the outside shortly as well. So I'm just going to go to external right now, and I'll maybe just show you guys the car when I get there.
A few minutes later.
Yeah, I made it myself.
How?
Like you use the front part of
what car?
My car, the EG8. Yes. And then you use the EG6 bottom in.
But where did you get there? Didn't
you have to import the EG6 and then basically just add, you have to plastic weld the two together. It's a whole trip I have. I'm gonna show everyone on my YouTube channel. Well, I'll just seen a few pictures. I think these are on
Instagram.
That shows the whole process and how I did it. I'll show you now soon. But what do you say? Do you see any bad? There is a few scratches that I actually want to show you that's very bad.
This car was polished before.
Is it? Badly done? Okay, but obviously you'll see in the white pieces, no? It was.
No,
I'm gonna make a video of this, no? Of our discussion or whatever, is it fine? What do you say?
Let's take a video of me taking the dents out also.
Yeah. Come on, let's go see. This is the only concern right now.
Yeah, no, that's off.
I'm gonna go to Dent Expert. They are friends of mine, so I'm maybe gonna go there. No. So yeah.
Yeah, but most of the stuff that you want off can come off.
Is it?
Yeah.
But look at these specific ones.
By the back.
Yeah, you saw that, no?
I'm gonna explain to you.
But this is obviously an issue here. This one can't be fixed.
That one can't be fixed.
Mm-hmm.
This one can be visually minimized.
Yeah.
Because now the issue with this, it's already indented. See when you run your nail over it. You can feel it. Yeah. So that one might be a bit of a problem.
We can minimize its visibility right now so that it don't stand out so much.
But that's fine.
It's a spider web.
And
that is actually this is
must be fixed.
Is that PPF? No,
I think this is
No, that's PPF bro.
Oh yay, now some of our language on the video.
It's fine, I'll just blurp it out. Don't worry. But yeah, you say you will be able to sort. And there's also like kind of swirl marks.
Yeah, swirl marks is also gonna come. Marks gonna come off. But now, there's some paint that's off, obviously, by the door.
Is it?
Yeah.
Because of the previous polish.
No, that's not from polishing.
Oh.
This is from when they opened up in the garage.
Oh, okay. Oh, knocking against the wall, yeah. But other than that, do you think you can sort out everything?
Yeah.
And you said only by the 22nd you're free? After?
After. You see that weekend I'm going out to Joburg.
What are you doing in Joburg?
I'm from them.
Oh.
Yeah.
So I was even lucky to get you here right now also.
So I'm just going to see family.
Okay.
And upon my return then we can look at him.
I actually saw that kind of over there. I see this now.
Okay, that I might need to flex
out. So what does that mean?
That's orange peel. So they try to touch up here.
Oh, I see here also, no? Do you have something to remove the overspray?
Yeah, I can remove it.
I hope it's not going to be a big deal for you. Like, is it fine? Is everything chilled with the price that we agreed on? But yeah, I think
the
you should.
The only challenge I might have is getting in between there. See, these letters are no longer properly stuck on.
And I don't think you should remove it also.
No, I'm not going to remove it. I'm going to cover it, but I'll work around it.
Yeah.
But that there in between is going to remain.
But I actually want you to inspect like everything, like you just discovered that now.
Yeah.
I think you should maybe just look around the car and then you can take it from there.
Open the hood.
It's hot?
Yeah, flipping hot bro. Nah, okay, that was fine.
This is original.
Oh, okay, yes. And this isn't.
So the thinner panel would be the one that's original, this one would be more thicker because
this one
more
is thicker because it was replaced, yeah.
Yo guys, so I just finished speaking to the owner of External Shine. He did say he might be going on holiday, so the only time he will be available will be after the 22nd of this month, which is February. So that is the only time we will be able to actually have the car done. Like I mentioned, it's going to be a three-stage polish detail and then also clay bar treatment. So yeah, that is the only time that you'll be able to do it. He did do the inspection, there isn't much scratches that he can't fix, but yeah, there is a few things that he might not be able to fix. So I'm just going to go around to my friend at Dent Expert, maybe just ask him a quote on what it would be to fix that, things that need maybe paint. And then I also just spoke to a guy at Dent Magic. He actually knew my car, so we just had a chat, we took each other's numbers. He asked me actually for assistance on his car as well. He wants to do the old EG6 front, so that might just be coming to the channel as well. So yeah, I'm gonna go to Future Cars now. They also a polishing place or a car wash place. I will maybe just hear what their quote would be also as well. And then after that, maybe just go to Dent Expert. And then also guys, just another thing, I was fiddling around the car, putting it over to sport mode. I've been driving into comfort mode. It's pretty cool. And then also, I don't know if you guys can see this little orange mark over there. When a car comes to you in your blind spot on your right hand side, that that triangle basically turns red. So just to show you that there's a car coming on in your blind spot. That's pretty cool. So something I learned on the car as well. And then this is the option of making it actually into sport mode. You press that little button over there. You guys will just see it will change into sport mode. That makes a car also backfire a lot and makes the car much more faster. The gearing is much more faster, as well as the car becomes a little bit more louder as well. It's pretty cool. It's just a few things that I just learned on the car while driving it for this short bit. So yeah, we're just going to Future Cars.